Dear students, today we will continue exercise 5.4, sum number C. Here we will learn a new formula, product of numbers equal to HCF into LCM. In sum number C, question number 2, the given numbers are 24 and 20. First, we will find the product of 24 and 20. 24 into 20 equal to 480. Now we will find the HCF and LCM. Which process we are using here? We are using the division method. Now 24 and 20 divided by 2. So 2 12s are 24 and 2 10s are 20. Then 2 6s are 12 and 2 5s are 10. In this step we are getting coprime numbers. 6 and 5 are coprime number. So stop here. Now we will find HCF and LCM from this only. Now we know what is the LCM of these two numbers. We will multiply all these numbers. 2 into 2 into 6 into 5. That is equal to 120. And what will be the HCF? Except these two coprime numbers, multiply the other numbers. That means 2 into 2. So HCF equal to 2 into 2, 4. Then we are finding product of HCF and LCM. HCF is 4 and LCM is 120. So 120 into 4 equal to 480. Now from this formula what we are getting, that product of numbers equal to HCF into LCM. Here our product of number is 480. And product of HCF and LCM, that is also equal to 480. So these two numbers are equal. So our product of numbers equal to HCF into LCM. Now question number 4. Numbers are given 33 and 22. Product means we will multiply these two numbers, 33 into 22, that is equal to 726. Now we will find LCM and HCF. We are using the division method. 33 and 22 is divisible by 11. 11 3s are 33, 11 2s are 22. When we are finding LCM, multiply all these numbers. 11 into 3 into 2 equal to 66. And when we are writing HCF, except these two coprime numbers, we will write down all the numbers. So here the only one number is here, 11. So HCF equal to 11. Now product of HCF and LCM, 66 into 11 equal to 726. Again, use that formula here. Product of two numbers equal to 726. HCF into LCM equal to 726. So these two are equal. That means product of two numbers equal to HCF into LCM. Now we will start exercise 5.5. Here we will start the sums using the formula, that product of two numbers equal to HCF and LCM. Read question number 1. The HCF and LCM of two numbers are 48 and 288 respectively. One of the numbers is 144. Find the other number. So HCF equal to 48, LCM equal to 288. One number is 144. First we will find the product of HCF and LCM. 288 into 48 equal to 13824. And when we are finding the other number, product which is equal to 13824 divided by one number is 144, one number. So here we are using that formula, product of two numbers equal to HCF into LCM. First find HCF into LCM. When we are finding the other number, product of HCF into LCM divided by the one number, 144. 144 9s are 1296. Subtract these two numbers. We are getting 86. Write down 4 here. 144 6s are 864. So our other number is 96. Question number 2. The product of two numbers is 600. Their LCM is 60. Find their HCF. So here product of two numbers is given, that is equal to 600. LCM is given. When we are finding HCF, product 600 divided by LCM, 60. So 60 ones are 60, 10 is here, write down 0. So a save equal to 10. So when we are finding one number or ACF or LCM, we have to divide. Before that, we will find the product. Question number 3. Find the largest number that divides 280 and 490 without leaving a remainder. So when we are finding a largest number, just remember one thing. If you can find the ACF of that two number, you will get the largest number. So here we are using the prime factorization method to get the ACF. Write down the number 280 and 490. 280 equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 7. Similarly, 490 equal to 2 into 5 into 7 into 7. Now mark the common factor. 2 is common here, 15 is common and 17 is common. So what will be the ACF? Write down 12 from here, 15 from here and 17 from here. Now 5 2s are 10, 10 7s are 70. 70 is the ACF. After that, write down the answer that 70 is the largest number that divides 280 and 490 without leaving a remainder. So when we are finding the largest number, if you can find the ACF, that will be your answer. In question number 4, the question is find the largest number that divides 232 and 157 leaving a remainder of 7. So here also you have to find the largest number, that means you have to do ACF. But here the numbers are leaving a remainder 7. When in the question it is given that the numbers are leaving a remainder 7, first we will subtract a remainder from the given numbers. So here our given numbers are 232 and 157. First subtract 7 from 232, we are getting 225. Then subtract 7 from 157, we are getting 150. After that, use the prime factorization method to get ACF. This is the prime factorization method of 225 and 150. What was the prime factorization method? We will divide this number with prime number only. Now 225 is not divisible by 2, so start with 3. 375s are 225. 325s are 75. 5 5s are 25. 5 is a prime number. Stop here. So 225 equal to 3 into 3 into 5 into 5. Similarly, 150 is divisible by 2 because unit place digit is 0. 275s are 150. Then 75 is divisible by 3. 325s are 75. And 5 5s are 25. So 150 equal to 2 into 3 into 5 into 5. Now mark the common factor. This 3 is common, this 5 is common and this 5 is common. So write down the ACF equal to 3 into 5 into 5. 13 from here, 15 from here and 15 from here, that is equal to 75. After that, write down the answer that 75 is the largest number that divides 232 and 157 leaving a remainder of 7. So when we are finding the largest number, we have to find the ACF. This is clear. Now if in the question it is mentioned that without leaving a remainder, then just find the ACF of that given numbers. And if in a question it is mentioned that leaving a remainder of 7, then subtract 7 from that two given numbers. After that, find the ACF. Then you will get the largest number. Thank you, children.